driven into the infected blood inquiry, the man whose evidence campaigners have waited decades to hear.
I swear by Almighty God
that the evidence I shall give,
that the evidence that I shall give,
shall be the truth,
shall be the truth.
Finally, compelled to answer questions, Kenneth Clarke. He was a minister, then Secretary of State for the Department of Health in the 1980s, as the blood contamination scandal came to light. But, he said, the issue hardly ever came across his desk.
I was never the minister directly responsible for blood products. I was never asked to take a decision on blood products. I never intervened to take a decision on blood products.
Factor VIII was the name given to a blood clotting product given in transfusions, mainly to haemophiliacs. By 1983, there were fears products imported from America contained hepatitis and HIV. In this TV interview, Kenneth Clarke talked about producing more in the UK and how to make Factor VIII safe.
We're taking expert advice on whether heat treatment will be a proper protection against AIDS.
Which I highlighted in my evidence.
Tony Faruja lost his father and two uncles to AIDS and hepatitis contracted through blood transfusions. He watched the inquiry today and wants answers about how much politicians knew and when and how it affected their decisions.
We want the truth. You know, we seem to be getting that, well, that wasn't my responsibility, but I sort of poked my head in and had a look, and it's an absolute insult to the families, and they're sitting in that room today listening to Kenneth Clarke just act, I think, like he did in 1983. Well, it's only haemophiliacs. It's almost like we didn't matter.
Kenneth Clarke will be asked whether the government hid information and why he opposed compensation in two further days of evidence. The infected and affected will listen to every word. Tessa Chapman, 5 News.